Hello, my big data friends. Sean Pitts back again with another Grafana Quick Start. In this video, we're going to be showcasing how to get up and running very easily with the Databricks plugin for Grafana Cloud. Now, it's important to note if we look here that the Databricks plugin, along with all the other enterprise data source plugins, are available across all tiers of Grafana Cloud, including the Cloud Free plan, which we'll be using today. So whether you're just getting started or you're already running production workloads, it's really super easy to get started. So let's jump in. Cool. So first things first, we're going to have to jump into Grafana and install the plugin. First thing we'll do here is we'll go into the left-hand navigation menu and then go down to connections and add a new connection. And here you'll see that there's all the plugins, integrations, and we're just going to search for Databricks. When you see this, you're going to click it. And if you have an enterprise license or the enterprise plugins enabled, you can see that there'll be an install option in the top right-hand corner. You can see that I already have this installed on my account, so no worries there. We're just going to add a new data source. So now we have a new data source created, but we got to fill in all the relevant information. So you'll see that there's host, HTTP path, and then the authentication type, which is a personal access token. So the real question is, how do we get this inside of Databricks? So let's jump into Databricks, and you can see here that I'm rocking with a light theme on both Grafana and Databricks. Does that make me a psycho? I don't know. But ultimately, what we'll do here is you can see we have a table with expected stats. I have some CSVs, as well as Databricks giving us some system metrics, such as like the billing and compute information. So maybe we want to visualize that and bring it closer to our telemetry. So how do we do that? Well, we go into the compute, and this is where we're going to get our connection details for the Grafana Databricks plugin. So we'll go into the just our starter warehouse that we're running, our SQL warehouse, and we'll go into connection details. You'll see that there's a server host name here. So we're going to copy that. We'll pop that into the host. And then we'll get our HTTP path, which is right here. And then we'll need to generate a personal access token. It's actually pretty convenient because in Databricks, you can just create a personal access token directly from here. We'll open that up in a new tab. And we'll generate a new token. So we'll just say for visualization, and we can set a lifetime of this. Let's just say I want to do 30 days. So we'll generate this token. It'll give you it one time. Make sure to copy it and put it somewhere safe, because if not, you'll lose it and you won't have it anymore. So then we just jump back in and we're going to use this personal access token. There are also alternative options such as the OAuth pass-through, OAuth M2M, and the Azure on behalf of. So you can select those if you want. We'll click save and test, and you see that this might just take a few minutes, but it should just take a few seconds, and it'll say the data source is working. So now we can actually jump into the explore view and start to look at our Databricks data. So in here, you'll notice that we have a very easy like plug and play option for creating queries. We see our schemas here. So if we go back into Databricks, this aligns with what's in our org. So if we look at the default information schema in MLB, the default and information schemas are going to be there out of the box, but the MLB is a custom schema that I created. So if we go into Explore, we click on MLB, you can see that we have a table called Expected Stats. And in here, I really have all the players from the 2024 MLB season and all their statistics. So if I pull this, you'll see that it actually creates an SQL query for me, so I don't have to do this. You can write your own custom code here, so it'll automatically convert it over into the code section, but we'll show you how to do this when it comes to the compute and billing information that you want to see inside Databricks. So let's jump into the builder. We'll run this query, and you can see that we get the name of all of our columns, or the column full name, from our expected stats table in Databricks. So now, what if we want to create a dashboard for this? Cool, so taking this Databricks data that we just queried for and putting it into a Grafana dashboard is actually quite simple. All we have to do is click add in the top right hand corner and click add to a dashboard. We're going to open this up in a new tab in a new dashboard, although we could inject it into an existing dashboard. So let's do that now. You can see that we get our existing explore query into a panel here. Let's stretch this out. And then let's go into the edit tab. Okay. We'll move myself over a little bit so we can actually see this. And you can see now that we are looking at this data. However, we want to look at everything that comes along with it. Right now, we're only looking at the full name, but what else do we get with it? So when we run this query, our table is going to change and give us all the columns, right? So now we can see batting average, slugging percentage, and maybe that's what I want to visualize. Maybe I just want to see the full name of the player and the batting average. I want to filter out the rest of this crap. So we can actually do a select. We'll do a full name, for the column, and then we'll also add another one and add the batting average. We'll run this query again, and now you can see that we only have two columns. Maybe we want to visualize this in something else than a table. Tables are cool, but maybe we want to make it a little prettier. So we can do a bar chart. You can see that a bar chart is a pretty good way of representing the data here. We can see that Aaron Judge is clearly leading the league right now with the biggest bar. However, this may not be the best way because you can see our x-axis is a little messy and all these are very squished together. So what if we choose a horizontal orientation for our x-axis? You're going to see that now this shifts over a little bit. So now everything's on the x-axis. So if we go back to the dashboard and stretch this out a little bit, you can see now that all of our players really fit here, which is nice. If we want to go back into the edit and maybe make this prettier, we can scroll down and choose the gradient mode to be hue. And now we have quite a pretty visualization of all the batting averages from 2025 of the top players. So now we can save this real quick. And we can just make this a new dashboard. We'll call this MLB stats. And we'll save this. So now we have our dashboard and we can continue to add visualizations here. But one thing I wanted to show you was how do you get something like billing data from Databricks, right? So what if you want to see, okay, how much is my SQL warehouse costing me? How much are my compute resources costing me? Well, it's actually quite simple as well. We just have to write custom queries. And since the plugin accepts the SQL editor, we can write custom SQL queries for this. So let's click edit, we'll click add, and we'll add another visualization. Let's make this a table just for the time being. And then we're gonna have to choose our data source again. So let's look up the Databricks data source. And you can see again that we're probably going to not want the MLB schema in this case, right? So what do we actually wanna get? Well, if we look back into the Databricks UI, you can see that there is the information or the system catalog. And then under here, we get a bunch of stuff like the compute resources, like the warehouses, maybe we want to see billing information such as the usage and so forth, right? So how do we actually get that data and how do we write the SQL query for it? Well, what we're going to do is we're going to jump back into the edit panel. We're going to grab a query that allows us to do so. And in this case, I'm going to be honest, I use Claude to generate this for me. But you can see that we're selecting the usage date and we're representing it as a time field. We're taking the billing origin product and making it a product field. And the same thing, we're calculating the usage quantity, which is just another column that's giving us the actual usage quantity. And then we're naming this total usage. And we're getting this from the system billing.usage. So if you go back into here, we can see that we look at system billing usage. That's what we're getting, right? And then we're grouping it by the usage date, the billing origin product, and we're ordering it by the usage date. So whenever I change this, essentially, what's going to happen is we're going to get the correct data for it. So let's run this. We'll run it for the last hour. This might just take a moment. And you can see now that we get the per product, the total usage. Now these are in different units, so we might actually want to eventually get the units along with it. So if we go back into the Catalog Explorer, and maybe we're looking at the usage, and we look at all of the data that comes along with it, it gives us the comment of what each field means. So maybe we want to get the usage unit as well. So let's grab that. And let's throw it into our panel. We'll just say usage unit as unit. Awesome. And then we'll add this group by as well. So now when we run this query, you'll see that now we get our unit. So we have DBUs here for the SQL and interactive. And in this case, the SQL is our SQL warehouse. And if you are curious about how the Databricks billing works, you can look up the product SKUs for Databricks, and there's actually a pretty good representation of all the SKU groups. So you can see how everything sort of reflects. And this is a great way to bring cross telemetry into Grafana. So if you want to view the billing and usage of Databricks, if you want to view MLB player stats all in one dashboard, or maybe you want to bring in logs from another data source, you have it all unified in one view. So thank you for tuning in. I hope you got a lot out of this video, and I'll catch you in the next one. Take it easy.